Good morning, student. Today I am here to discuss a very interesting phenomenon of refraction which occurs in nature, and that is why stars appears to be twinkling. But before I proceed, I will revise some topics related to refraction which we have already studied. Suppose this is the interface, student. Interface means this is the first medium, this is the second medium. And suppose I am taking this medium to be air and this medium to be glass. Here I am drawing a normal. You already know refractive index of air is less as compared to refractive index of glass. So I have drawn the arrow upward. N stands for refractive index. Now what happens when light travels from air to glass, student? It is traveling from rarer to denser medium. It will bend towards the normal, student. Already we know it. It will bend towards the normal. Okay, student. Now, again I am taking another interface. Now suppose first medium is glass and second medium is air. Again I am drawing the normal. Now light is traveling from glass to air. Now student, this is denser medium. This is rarer medium. It will bend away from the normal. So how it will travel? It will bend away from the normal, student. Why light is bending? Because the medium is having different refractive index. That is why it is bending. So these two phenomena you have to remember. When light travels from rare to denser, it bends towards the normal. When light travels from denser to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. Now student, one more factor which affects the refractive index, and that factor is temperature. Temperature affects the refractive index. What is that effect? Higher the temperature, lesser will be the refractive index. Okay, student, lower the temperature, higher will be the refractive index. I am writing it short here, RI. Now I will talk something about our atmosphere. Our atmosphere, student, as you know, the density is not same throughout. Different gases are present at different places. So what happens is, the refractive index of atmosphere varies with height. First thing. Second, already we have studied temperature affects the refractive index, and you already know, student, that the temperature of the atmosphere also changes with time. Since temperature is changing, hence the refractive index of atmosphere also changing with time. This is very important, student. Refractive index of atmosphere is also changing with time. Okay, student, these two factors you have to remember. Now I am coming to our subtopic. Why stars appears to be twinkling? Already you got the idea of atmosphere, student. Now, as you know, the light from the star travels a very large distance while traveling towards the earth. Suppose, student, this is the earth. This is the earth, student. And a person is standing here. And the ray of light, this is a star. This is a star, student. This is the actual position. Now, student, the ray of light from the star will not come straight because the refractive index of the atmosphere is varying. So it will come in a curved path like this. And it will reach the eye of the person. It is curved, coming in a curved path, student. This means now this star will appear to be a student here. This is the apparent position of the star. Apparent position. Means the star is actually at this position, but it appears to be here. Now one more thing, student. Just now I told you that the temperature is varying with time. Temperature is varying with time. Due to this, the refractive index is also varying with time. So light will not always follow this curved path. It will change its path, student. It will follow so many paths. And every time its position will change with respect to time. Now star will appear to be here. Sometimes star will appear to be here, student. Because the refractive index is varying with time. Refractive index is varying with time. So the light will follow many curved paths. Light will follow many curved path, which will result in the position of the star. The position of star will vary with time. And student, it is this thing, the position which is varying with time, it will appear to the eyes as it is twinkling, student. As it is twinkling. In childhood, you used to hear the song about the twinkling of the star. How I wonder what you are. Now you got the exact phenomena, student, the exact secret. Why it is happening? So student, why it is happening? It is the refraction. Refractive index is varying. Two causes. One is due to the different heights, the different refractive index, and due to the change in temperature. Change in temperature, student. Change in temperature. Refractive index is varying. Can you see how the position of the star is changing with time? Sometimes light is appearing to come from this side. Sometimes light is appearing to come from this side. See how the star position is changing. So it appears to be flickering, student. The light appears to be flickering. And thus, the stars appears to be twinkling. Now one more question which arises here, student, is then along with the star we have planets also. Then why planets does not twinkle? This question also arises. Why planets do not twinkle? Because the same thing is happening with planet as it is happening with star. So student, remember why it does not appear to be twinkling. The first reason is planets are much closer. Planets are much closer to Earth as compared to star. As compared to star. Second, the size of the planet are much bigger as compared to star. So what happens is the position of the planet due to refraction changes very little, which is not noticeable. It is not detected by our eye, and hence, student, the planet do not twinkle. So, student, the basic concept is clear. Why the stars appears to be twinkle, and why planets do not twinkle? The basic reason is refraction. Now, student, why the refraction occurs? That you understood, it is a refractive index is varying. So remember, student, the basic cause of refraction is actually the velocity of light is different in different media. Actually, it is maximum in vacuum or in air, and that is why, since the velocity is varying, so you say refractive index is varying, student. So again, I am revising, student. Why stars appear to be twinkling and planets do not appear? Because the stars are much far away. The position of the star changes in a large extent. Why? Due to the change in temperature, due to the change in refractive index. Light follows many curved paths, student. So today in this class, student, I will discuss now one numerical. One theory I have discussed. Now let's solve one numerical. This numerical is based on lens, student. Numerical on lens. Okay, student. Let's suppose I am taking, first let me write lens formula. What is lens formula, student? You know all the parameters. What is V? It is image distance from optical center. Image distance from optical center. Every distances are to be measured from optical center. What is U? Object distance from optical center. What is F? Focal length of lens. Okay, student. Now, one of the most important thing here to understand is new Cartesian sign convention, student. New Cartesian sign convention, student. This only creates problem while solving the numerical. So that you understand first. Suppose, student, this is the lens. I am taking biconvex lens. Okay, student. This is optical center. Optical center. This is principal axis, already you have studied. Okay, student. Now object is on this side. This is the object. Say it will form image on other side. One ray parallel to principal axis. It will pass through the focus. Another ray, optical center, it will pass undeviated. So this is the image, student. This is the image. Now, student, the sign convention, try to understand. Remember, choose this point, optical center, as the origin. Choose optical center as origin. Okay, student. So this is the x-axis, as in mathematics you do, student. This is x-axis, student, and this is y-axis. This is the first thing which you have to do. Now, student, this is positive side. This is positive side. Now, student, I have to measure object distance. See, object is here. So I have to go to the negative side from optical center. See, student. And that is why the sign of U will be negative. If the image is in this case here, to find the image distance, I have to go this side. See, positive x-axis. See, student. So in this case, V will be positive. Okay, student. There are cases in which image forms this side only. So there V will become negative. So remember, this is the basic. Origin is here. And this is positive coordinate, as you draw in mathematics. Now, student, there is a confusion about this F. Because lens has two focal lengths. This side also focus is there. This side also focus is there. So we have made the sign convention of lens fixed. Remember, student, F for convex lens is positive. And F for concave lens is negative, student. This you have to remember always. This sign will change according to the situation. But this will remain fixed. One more thing, student. When you apply the lens formula, out of these three, two may be given, one may be unknown. So student, unknown should never be given any sign. The unknown quantity should not be given any sign. Remember this, student. You write sign only to the known quantity. Okay, student? Now, one more thing, student. Another term is there. That is magnification. Okay, student, magnification, denoted by M, magnification, it is actually height of the image upon height of the object, and lens formula, this is also equal to V upon U, student. This formula you have to remember. Again, for height, there is a sign convention. If it is above the principal axis, I have to start see positive Y axis. This height positive will be taken. If it is below the principal axis, the height should be taken as negative. That is Cartesian sign convention, as you do in mathematics, student. So, student, these are the two basic formulas which you have to understand. Now, let's solve a numerical. Suppose I take this question, okay? Suppose, student, the F is given to be 15 centimeter and it is convex lens. Okay, student. And suppose the object is kept at 20 centimeters. I have to find out position of the image. Also, suppose height of the object is given to be 2 centimeters. I have to find out height of the image and also the nature. Okay, student. This question I have to solve. So let's see how to solve it. First, you write the given quantities. Focal length, student, convex lens. Just now I told you have to remember plus 15. Student, object distance. Object is here. I have to come this side, negative x-axis. Sign convention, minus 20. V is unknown, no sign. So I will apply the lens formula. Okay, student. Then I will substitute the values. 1 by V minus, student, U. U again minus. Minus 20 I have to write. Is equal to 1 by 15. Minus minus becomes plus, and when taken to shifted to other side, it will again become minus. So 1 by 15 will be equal to, 1 by V will be equal to 1 by 15 minus 1 by 20. Now simple mathematics, student. This comes out to be 1 by 60. So student, V comes out to be plus 60. What is the meaning of this plus, student? Means the image is on the this side. This length is 60. image is on the positive side, student. Okay. Now I will find out, student, height of the image. Now I will use this formula. Height of the image upon height of the object, student, given 2 cm. It will be taken as +2. V upon u, student, V came out to be +60. U is given, student, -20. See, student, how much I am getting height of the image. It is -6, student. This you have to understand. What is the meaning of -6? Minus means the image is formed below the principal axis. In this figure, though the image is appearing smaller, but actually it is bigger in size in this case, student. So height of the image is how much? Height of the image is how much, student? -6 cm. Now, student, let me find out magnification. I will rub this part of the board. I have to find out value of m. So I can use any of the ratio, either this or this. If I use this ratio, student, hi upon ho, hi already -6 and ho +2, I am getting m is equal to -3. I can use this formula also. M is equal to v by u. V is +6p and u is -20. Again I am getting -3, student, c's. Same thing I am getting. Now, what is the meaning of -3, student? This you have to understand. Minus, first minus sign. The sign of m is minus, means the image is real, student. This you have to remember. The image is real because m is found out by height and it is negative. This means the image is below the principal axis. Second thing, student, about this 3. The image is 3 times the size of the object. The image is 3 times the size of the object, student. This is the meaning, student. This is the, student, meaning of this. So, got it, student? Once again, just revise it. Start with this formula. Write, substitute the values with proper sign convention, taking this as origin. Find out the value of V. V came out to be +60. Then use this formula. Hi upon ho. This formula is equal to 60 by hi upon ho is equal to v by u. This formula is utilized. You can use any part of this formula. Either this or this, anything you can use. Height of the image minus meaning I make you understood before only. The image is formed below the principal axis. Height of the image. Then I calculated magnification. This formula, we use two formula, use same form, same answer I got. And negative means it is real image. Okay, student. Now let's solve one numerical related to concave lens, student. Now the lens is concave. Say I am taking the same data, student. I am taking the same data, but I am changing the lens. Now the lens is concave. I am taking biconcave lens, student. Optical center is this. Here is somewhere object is kept, student. This is the object. Okay, student. Other data I am taking out, taking same, student, this same thing. Only the lens I have replaced. Now, student, see the sign convention. First thing, F I have to take -50. Concave lens, focal length is negative. Again, the coordinate system, this is origin. This is positive x-axis. This is y-axis. This side positive, this side negative. Okay. Object is here. This is u. So u will be minus 20 square. Now I apply the Lenz formula. V I have to find out. U is minus 20. So 1 by V will become minus this plus, this will become plus and that side will become minus. Student, now you see the sign of V, I am getting minus 60 by 7. Student, see sign, student, minus. Minus means the image will be on this side of the lens. Now I am finding the height, student. Height of the image, height of the object, height of the image, I have to find out, height of the object plus 2, V student minus 60 by 7, U student how much, minus 20. Now if I solve it, I will get 60 by 7 20 into 2. This you solve it, student. Now see, student, height of the image is plus 6 by 7. It is 6 by 7. So the height is less than the size of the object. And sign plus means, student, what is the height plus means? The image is formed above the principal axis. So this means, student, if I see the image formation, first ray will travel like this. Second ray will travel like this. If I trace it backward, this is the image, student. This is the image. This is the image, student. Can you see it is forming above the principal axis? So I got the positive. And compare with the height of the object. It is smaller than this. Okay, student. Now I will calculate magnification. Magnification, any formula I can use. I am using this formula. V how much, student? Minus 60 by 7. U how much? Minus 20. So M is equal to, this will become plus 60 by 7 into 20. See, student, the value of m is less than 1 and sign is positive. Positive means the image is virtual and it is diminished in size, smaller in size. It is smaller in size. So, in case of concave lens, remember, student, the sign of V is always negative. In this question though, we have to find out. So I have not given any sign. I got the answer negative. So in case of concave lens, student, remember the image is always virtual. You know it. Image is always virtual. And the sign of V will also be always negative, student. And the size of the image will be always smaller than the size of the object, student. So let's once again revise it, student. I think it is clear now. Take optical center as the origin. Draw positive x-axis, positive y-axis. Now sign convention. Object is here. So I have to travel in the negative x-axis. So minus sign. If the image is here, plus sign. Height above the principal axis, positive sign. And then I have to use these two formula with proper sign convention. Okay, student? Okay, student, we will continue with the next topic in the next class. Thank you.